Ankita.
So we are from Wingify, and we are going to speak on a topic which is web push notification automation mystery solved. So yes, indeed, we have solved the mystery. Like these are web push notifications for which there is no automation right now, indeed available. So not even Google has provided it. Like they have started developing, but no, there is no great progress on that regard. So like we started on working on it. So what we'll do is we'll demo our tool, as well as I'll just quickly run down of the agenda, like what all we'll be covering. So how many of you are having knowledge about web push notifications?
One, two, three.
Okay. Not. Yeah. So mobile push notifications were there. Then Chrome launched about a year back web push notifications as well. So that is great. So we'll be discussing what are push notifications, the concept behind it, that is the service workers, then testing those notifications, our tool PushNot and its demo and its further scope. So talking about push notifications, so every one of us are like most probably well versed with the mobile notifications. Like you must be having applications like Facebook, Twitter and whatnot, any shopping website. So they are pushing content every day. Every day and night they are sending you product updates or any offer updates. So they are using. So this was not present in mobile web. So have you seen such kind of a pop-up or something like which we generally want to click on the block button because we are afraid that it will spam us? So these are the Chrome notifications. So clicking on allow will like you will get subscribed to them, and any new further updates you will be receiving on your desktop, on your laptop, wherever you are accessing the same. So this is how it looks in Chrome, the first screenshot, and the second one is for the Firefox. They have also, like, Chrome launched it a year back, and Firefox did, like, a couple of months back. So coming back to push notifications, so these are basically timely, good, engaging updates which websites want to send to their users, and they're really engaging. Like, there were certain case studies which proved that classic email like email notification and email matching, those are turning out to be really sad now. Like they are very less conversion rates and very less click rates, etc. But push notifications, they know that a person is accessing his browser, and once it is subscribed, so even websites like leading newspapers, Hindutimes.com, Times of India and whatnot, so they all are these days using push notifications. So one major advantage is that your browser should not be open. Like if it is open, it's fine. But once you have subscribed to them, there is no need for the browser to be open. Just like mobile apps. Once you have installed that, say, Myntra application, then no longer you need like to keep it running to receive such updates. Similarly, if we talk about subscribed users, so yes, once you are subscribed, you are done. Like every time you will be getting these notifications. Once your script is running, there is a background script running over there. So what enables, like what is the technology behind? So the technology behind is the service workers. Service workers are basically like these are the background scripts which are running in parallel or off the shelf. They are running in the background. They do not have like access to the DOM, or like they are not at all related to the web page, but they do open like a like opportunities to like basically it's a programmable network proxy, so which is listening to all the requests coming on your browser and reciprocating to it. Saying which, since it's a network proxy, so HTTPS is needed. Like you cannot have any website which is HTTP could note down the push notifications. But saying which, like nothing is impossible. So there are hacks available in which if you are having a HTTP website, there are certain workarounds for which you can still use push notifications. Certain SaaS players are out there are helping you do that. So as I said, it's a background service script. So it cannot access DOM directly. Also, it does not have any access to the local cache, local storage, or IndexedDB. It does not have any access to that. So while implementing push notifications, service workers are having a particular life cycle. So it starts from, like, first of all, it's the installation step. Then it's the activation. Activation could either lead you to a successful install or maybe an error. So this point we need to take care, like all the developers or even if the QAs are implementing service worker. So they need to maintain that all the steps are mandatory and they are being fulfilled. If your service worker is not installed, then definitely you won't receive any of the notifications or any of the other benefits of the service worker. So push notifications is a one use case of service worker. There are a lot of use cases of service worker, namely like it is used for caching of the resources. Certain background tasks could be run, like you are off your browser, you have closed your browser, but still there are certain monitoring tasks which would be basically sending data to the applications you have accessed it before. So knowing your pattern, things like that are being developed, but one major use case is push notifications. So while developing push notifications as a developer or as a QA, you need to follow the current life cycle, like starting from the registering to installation, then at the last, registering a push event listener, which will actually listen to all the notifications which your backend would be later sending on, and all your users would be getting it. Well, service workers can also decrease your web load time. So if you see that certain notifications are coming, generally there is an icon associated with it, just taking a use case. So those icons are also cached. Every time it's not that from the internet it is fetching that icon. If it gets updated, yes, there is a different protocol for a service worker. If it gets updated, you need to, you know, like either clear a cache, or generally these days people use it as a hack that update your, like append a random number to your script being fetched. Well, as I told you, like this is kind of a cumbersome task to do, like starting, many websites are implementing on their own as well. Like if you talk about Facebook.com or say track.in, so some of them are implementing service workers on their own, but since it's a cumbersome task, so there are certain SaaS-based companies which are helping you out, and even HTTP websites are enabled for them. Like even if you're having a HTTP website, you can still subscribe your users to push notifications and hence interact with them and send over. So certain players are there, like pushq.com, pushwish.com, izutu.com. So they just play like GTM or something. So they will give you a smart code. You can install it on any of your head tags. And there you go. Like people can now access your web application, subscribe to push notifications. One which is pushq. So this is our in-house tool. This is a SaaS application. So our demo will be using pushq. Like my website is a HTTP website, so I haven't implemented service worker on my own, but I'm using the service. So now the question comes, like, fine, you have developed your service worker, you have installed, and now like every user is getting notifications. But the point is how to automate them. So like very single approach, every manual tester must be doing, like it involves a lot of time, energy, like people would be sitting in hours, or say, consider scenario. These notifications are generally sent by marketers. So if a marketer wants to publish a product update or say any offer or something, so what he'll do is he'll release an update, or developer will provide them a CMS or kind of an API to hit to send the notification. Then the tester will basically wait for the notification, test its occurrence, like maybe that the data is perfectly received or not, the URL is correct or not, because if you click on the notification, they take you to a URL, which is the intent of the notification, that yes, get redirected to a particular content page or an offer page. So saying which, since classic approach, which is manual testing, is cumbersome and it's like kind of boring, so why not automate it? So as someone also mentioned, like there are screen comparison tools available. So maybe like take a test data, take a snapshot before sending the notification and one after that. So maybe you can do it like that. But if you're not into that, maybe use PushNot. So PushNot is basically a tool which we developed. So it's a specialized open source proxy tool for modifying, parsing, and fetching notifications. And this works for Firefox as well as Chrome. So Ankita will walk you down to its architecture, and we'll have a demo in a short while.
So PushNot is written in Node, and you need to have Node on your systems to run it. So I'll walk you through the architecture, how we are basically, what we are doing with PushNot. So you remember the steps in the life cycle. The first was registration. That was the crucial step. So here, when we are sending a registration request, our proxy tool intercepts it. So the response of the request is serviceworker.js. This is basically the file which contains methods and functions which implement the push notifications. You have methods which trigger a notification, you have methods which help you capture what the user what was the user's action on those notifications. So when we are intercepting this service worker.js, we are inserting our own payload into this file. This payload would not at all affect the existing functionality of the service worker, but it will have methods and functions which would enable us to capture the push notification response. So what gets registered on a browser is our modified service worker. It's like totally like the original one, but with some extra methods and functionalities. So once we have registered our modified service worker, the next is sending a push notification and receiving it. So you can send a push notification in two ways. If you have like your in-house development, then you can use the methods specified by the web API to do it. Or if you're using a third party, they provide you with an API endpoint along with your credentials related to your account, using which you can trigger a notification. So once a notification is coming in, again, our proxy intercepts it. It captures the response, the data which is sent in the notification, and saves it in a file. The format of the data is in JSON, so we create a JSON file at our local systems and save it over there. After the data has been saved, we again reroute the request back to the browser so that we can actually see the notification on the browser. So everything works fine, just we came in between and captured the response. So a typical response looks like this. It has title, it has message, it has the URL on which of the landing page to be taken to, it has an icon. So you don't need to verify anything if you just verify all these values. It's a simple JSON format. You can create a JSON object and verify it. So once it is done, then before the demo, there are some prerequisite steps we need to follow. These are very important and crucial. So first is related to our proxy. As it's a proxy, it is running on some port. So we've given a flag port. By default, it runs on 9002 port, and if you have any other service running on that port, you can change it. The other one is domain. So it's a proxy tool. It is intercepting all the requests. So all SSL handshakes and HTTPS secure connections will break because it's a proxy. It won't consider your host as the correct host, origin as the correct origin. So if we provide the domain name, suppose my site is ankita.com and I provide domain equal to ankita.com or ankita, my proxy tool will just intercept requests coming from that particular domain. So all my other websites, all my other functionalities not belonging to that domain will still work. They'll work perfectly fine. Suppose, example, you have a case of push notification on Facebook sign up. So we want the sign up to happen. So if we use this domain flag and just specify our page's domain, then our Facebook sign up will work perfectly fine. Then it's a proxy. So we have to set up system proxy or browser proxy. In Chrome, we cannot set up proxy, so we have to do system proxy. Firefox gives us a capabilities option where we can set up proxy. So we need to set up the proxy same as pushnot's proxy. By default, a localhost 9002 port, otherwise whatever mentioned. The third is browser options while launching the browser. So by default, Firefox ignores all SSL certificate errors. Chrome does not. So first flag if we are using Chrome is ignore SSL certificate errors. The second is, you remember that allow block pop-up. So there is no way to like click on that. So but there are browser preferences which sets all these values. So profile default content setting value notifications. It has three. It can take three values: 0, 1, 2. 0 is default, 1 is always allow, and 2 is block. So if we give it as 1, it won't ever open up that allow block box. By default, all allow block pop-ups will be accepted. So let's go to the demo. So the demo depends a lot on the internet connection. So the first step was starting the proxy. So I'll provide a GitHub link from where you can just download our proxy and start it. The start command is node start.js, which is our initial file. And I've given the domain as Jatin because my website is hosted on jatin.wingify.com. So my proxy has started. It's listening on port 9002. So the next step was setting up system proxy. I'll go to my system settings. I'll set up HTTPS proxy, localhost, and the same port as my pushnot service. Once I've done that, I need to launch my browser with the desired capabilities. So I'm using Protractor here because we are very much familiar with it. Otherwise, you can use any other language. All Java, Python, Ruby, every language gives you the option of setting browser capabilities. So I'm using Chrome in Chrome options, I'm using ignore certificate errors argument and a preference. So with Firefox, you don't need to use the ignore certificate errors argument because it automatically does that, but you definitely need to use the other preference. So my browser capabilities are set, and now I'm going to start a test. So this test has some very basic steps. It opens up a page which has a service worker enabled. Okay, so it opens up a page. You see that allow, don't allow notification. That is a push through custom pop-up box. Other players don't give it. It clicks on allow, then you get this box. In this is the place where you would get that allow, block, the system dialog type of thing. So it automatically clicks on allow, then it triggers a push notification via API. So we are not using our own service worker, we are using push through, and it triggers a notification. Due to internet connections, our notification is not here. Let's wait for it. Oh, it's here. So this was the notification which I just sent. It's here, and now because of our proxy, as it's received, it has definitely been saved in our response file. So our test is run. You can see the first is accept. The pop-up which was open, it accepted. Then this was push notification has been sent successfully. We sent it via API. Then this is the content of the notification. Title, message, and the URL. We didn't print out image. So we printed out here, but if you want to see the response, you can see it here. It's in JSON format. You have title, we have message, we have URL, we have icon URL and other things. So we have successfully captured it in a file, and now we can just use our existing frameworks to read this file and convert it into a JSON object and assert it. Yeah, so our reports are also here.
Maybe we can try a failed scenario, like we could edit the notification or something. And
okay.
Sure.
HTTP? Fine.
Must be HTML5 logs. Using service worker?
So this would work only for service workers because we are adding that payload, right? So that is a service worker specific.
So that must be system notifications. This is a web push notification. This is triggered by the browser. So
maybe we can look into it, how it's implemented, and then
I think there must be a preference. Like, we set a preference for 012 for the auto allow and block. So there must be a Chrome option, and associated there would be a preference. So there are preferences also. One is Chrome options, and the other one is preferences.
So this preference, if you see, it is notifications preference only. it's not setting all the preferences. And here in the browser, if you click here, you can see location, camera. So there must be a camera preference which you would have to set. So notifications is asked by default. When I set it as one, this is always allow on this side. It gets automatically set. So for camera, there must be a specific preference. So current scope is, we have tried and tested it with Chrome and Firefox. So a little difference in how notifications are received in Chrome and Firefox is the JSON object. In Chrome, we get it as message. In Firefox, it's MSG. So keep that in mind if you want to build a generic system for both the browsers. Currently, we cannot store multiple notifications. As we are writing onto a file, we are removing it every time. So if multiple notifications come, then the latest one is the one which is in the file and you will access that. So all previous notifications would be definitely lost.
So you can include a step in your script, like to delete the JSON. Currently,
right. Good point. So maybe we can add that, but the thing is, if we duplicate notifications,
well, duplicate, I don't think so. Like, if you are subscribed in more than one browser, then definitely yes.
Yeah, you trigger a notification twice. That is totally dependent on browser and network connection. Your system speed, your network connection, basically that. We cannot even, sometimes it happens with us also, it comes in 5 seconds, it comes in 30 seconds. It's not at all 100% reliable push notification. Sometimes you trigger it, but it's not at all received. So that is also one drawback of Service Worker, that it's not 100% reliable. The test. So push note will capture it as soon as it comes, but when, at what point of time it will come, we cannot determine. We will like always be listening on the port for any push notification to appear. So in our test, we have to wait for like 30 seconds by default. Like, if it doesn't come in this much time, then it's not a good thing. So maybe in our test we can build this scenario to wait for the push notification. It might come in 5 seconds, it might not come in 30. So we, as like, even you, if you are like testing it out, you don't know till what point of time to wait. And there's no mechanism to ensure that it should come within 5 seconds or 10 seconds or something like that. So that has to be handled in the test. And we've uploaded a sample script in JavaScript right now on our GitHub repository, so that you can have a look what all Chrome preferences are to be set and how did we trigger a notification reading and writing JSON responses. You can find our repository at github.com/AnkitaGupta2309. It's all in the slides and they would be available on Confingin. And if you want to know more about implementing service workers on your own, you want to try them out, you can go on developers.google.com. They have a very elaborate, simple, and step-by-step walkthrough procedure with code snippets available there, which you can just copy-paste in your code and try out push notifications for web, for your website. And PushCrew has developed case studies of their clients where they've actually captured with numbers how push notifications are effective than email communication or any other mode of communication. The numbers are really, there's a big difference in number. What happens with emails is it goes into junk, you don't read them, you don't open them a lot. But push notification, it's on your browser. You have to see that. It's up to you to click on that, but definitely you will see that. So that's pretty much about us. Do try it out. and it's pretty interesting. It was pretty interesting to work with service workers. It's a really a new thing which has come up in the market, and really interesting to work with them. Any questions or any more demos? We can do that. We have a lot of time left.
We can run it on Firefox, or maybe just like I was mentioning, we can send a notification and every one of you can receive it. Any queries you have, you can reach us out later. And do try out. Yeah. So you can fork it. It's open source. So we have released it. And just try out. There might be bugs even. So maybe you can squash some bugs over there. So and maybe corner cases. So one such is Chrome Android is also supported. So we haven't tried that out yet. So maybe someone would try that and maybe have a hands on it. Yes, a lot of challenges.
So the biggest one was SSL issues. So Chrome service workers, they all work on HTTPS and secure connections. As it's a background script, it listens. And it's a network proxy also, so SSL is a must. It is kind of like a man in the middle type of a thing. So you need SSL. So once we are like, how do we kind of insert our code so that it does not break the SSL authenticity? And still we receive our push notifications. So yeah. So one was that. The other one was, it's a background script. It does not have access to DOM, local cache, session cache, cookies, or any kind of thing. So once we've even inserted our script, how do we get the data out of it? So for that, we have implemented WebSockets. So we are listening on the same port, and the payload which we've inserted, it sends the data via WebSockets. So you inspect it using like Chrome Service Worker internals. But then if we have to do that, we have to open that particular page in the browser, then click on inspect, and then you write your code in that particular console. So that was very cumbersome. Plus, if your browser is not open, you still get the notification, right?
So basically, everything was getting printed. You're right. Like if you inspect, everything will get printed over there. All the console log statements and log statements would get printed. But the thing is that now you have to assert, right? So if you are manually clicking on it, then it's a manual testing. But if you have to assert on its own, then you have to get those logs, get those data back. The notification is sending you, like there were 8 things, right? Tag, title, message, URL. So you need to assert that whatever you had sent, it is actually being received. Because if you're not asserting, then yeah, so there is no point of asserting.
So, and you cannot assert from a console log. And you cannot assert from the objects. You can access them over there, but you cannot like access them with automation. Rendered at right place? No.
Not right. So that could be done in your automation script. Like we had launched a browser, you have accepted it. Maybe you could just kill the browser then and there once it is allowed, and then you will receive that notification.
So another thing is that all these... Yeah. Right. You can do that for location and basically its look. And another thing is that we are assuming that all these actions are native actions, like click, location and all. So they must be working fine. So this is basically for how we have implemented it. So this is testing that, not whether the click action for the native web API click action is working or not. It won't capture the screenshot. You need...
So we do.
Screenshot won't capture that. It captures the window size only. Nothing above or below the window. It doesn't capture anything else.
Okay. JavaScript is taking screenshot, but
so
if you will see, there are no mention of that notification in there, in those scripts.
You have AutoIt also, robot scripts, which basically insert the system commands. You can run the system commands for that. Right. We are assuming that it's a basic functionality and it would be working fine.
Pretty sure it must be possible with the preferences, because I was going through the list and I also like you showed. So you have to enable it or you have to disable it when it is coming. So there must be like definitely, if it's possible, just write to me or just give me your contact. I'll get back to you, because I have seen those things and it will definitely work.
Yeah, we can try it out. So those alerts are implemented by a service workers. So
those can be done by AutoIT, etc. Right?
So normal like automation can handle all those alerts. It's Windows. Yes. So you're talking about the yellow strips which come on top. Okay. So all that, like, can be handled as they're a part of browser only, so there are ways to handle them. Yes, not outside the browser window. Okay, thanks a lot, and like, try out service workers, it's a pretty interesting thing right now. Thank you.